this question that something about food.
I know, where's your mother going to
do? Eating fruit?
I do.
Oh, wait, yeah. I remember. Galatians 5:22. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. Amen. So the first fruit is love. Love, love, love. How can I show that I have love? I know! I'll go tell Lori from school that I love her. I've had a big crush on her since I was 5 years old. That means I love her, right? Anyway, I bet that will make her happy. And I can show that I have food too.
That's a pretty good warm-up.
Oh, hey, Lori.
Hey, Duke. What's up?
Not much. So, I've been meaning to tell you.
Yeah,
so I just wanted to tell you that I've really liked you ever since we were young, and well, here goes nothing. Right in the eye. Love stings.
Lori, the Bruiser Boncaccio? The only girl allowed to play on the boys' football team because she's bigger than all the boys put together?
Yep, that's the one. Took all my courage. But I puckered up and kissed her right on the cheek.
Uh-oh. You kissed her? Why did you kiss her?
Well, isn't that what love is? Kissing and hugging and being mushy?
Well, not really, Duke. I think you got it wrong. True love, the way God meant it, is really different.
Different? How is it different?
Well, on TV, it seems like love is always some guy and girl kissing. It's not just some lovey-dovey romantic fairy tale. In the Bible, it tells us that God loved us so much that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him will never die, but have eternal life.
Whoa, hold on. I didn't hear anything about kissing or hugging Lori the Bruiser in any of that stuff you said. Does God really love us that much?
You betcha.
I get it now. It's not about being mushy and romantic. It's about doing things for others and expecting nothing in return.
You got it, dude.
Cool. Well, I gotta go.
Where are you going?
To apologize to Lori and see if she needs help with her math homework. She is good at football, but has a hard time with math. Dude, I totally love your math.
That sounds like a good idea.
This is bad. This is really, really bad. I feel terrible. Why did I do that? Oh, geez, what am I gonna do? This is awful. Duke will never forgive me. God will never forgive me. Oh, no! God is probably so mad at me.
Lori, are you okay? Are you sick? You don't have a fever.
Oh, teacher Hannah, I don't think there's anything you can do for me now. I'm beyond help. I did something really bad. I don't even think God will let me into heaven now. This is unforgivable.
Now, Lori, nothing could possibly be that bad. It's okay. Just take a deep breath and tell me what happened.
Okay, so today I was just doing my usual workout routine. You know, 1,000 pull-ups and all. And then, all of a sudden, Duke comes out of nowhere and tries to kiss me. I didn't know what to do, so I just punched him in the eye. It all happened so quickly, and I wasn't thinking straight.
Wait. You punched him?
I told you it was bad. I think I hurt him really badly. He was in a lot of pain. God could never forgive something as bad as that, could he?
Lori, God forgives all of our sins, even the really bad ones. God loves us when we do good things, but he loves us even when we do bad things. God doesn't love the bad things, but he still loves us. All you have to do is ask God to forgive you, and then ask your friend to forgive you too.
Really? Thanks, Teacher Hannah. I feel better already. I'm going to go apologize to Duke now, and then go pray to God and ask for forgiveness.
Yay!
Oh, I think class is about to start. We should probably get going.
Okay, let's go.